CEO Elon Musk has shared a slideshow from a recent SpaceX all-hands meeting, revealing the company's current priorities, sources of pride, and the first official renders of a few future projects. SpaceX is working to complete building the world's most advanced internet infrastructure, that consists of launching at least 12,000 Starlink satellites to low Earth orbit. SpaceX depends on Starship's success to launch the next generation Starlink 2.0 satellites that will enable the company to provide high-speed internet access globally. SpaceX founder Elon Musk said, "The Starlink 2.0 satellites are going to be larger and more powerful, that it will require using a Starship to launch to orbit," he shared during a recent interview with YouTube channel Everyday Astronaut. Musk said that, SpaceX already manufactured the first Starlink 2.0 satellite, that will be part of the Starlink GEN2 system. Starlink 2.0 satellites feature inter-satellite laser link technology, that will enable satellites to communicate directly with one another, to transfer data at a much faster rate in orbit, without the need to receive data directly from a ground station. He said the Starlink 2.0 satellite is 7 meters, 22 feet, long and weighs about 1.25 tons, approximately 2,755 pounds. The Starlink 1.0 first generation satellites, that are currently in orbit weigh about 573 pounds. Musk says the Starlink Gen-2 system satellites are heavier, because they will feature, much more capable, technology. Just think of it like how many useful bits of data can each satellite do. Starlink 2.0 in terms of useful bits of data, is almost an order of magnitude better than a Starlink 1.0, he told Everyday Astronaut. The Starlink 2.0 satellites are too large to launch atop SpaceX's Falcon 9 rocket, which is capable of launching 50 to 60 Starlink 1.0 satellites to LEO, on a single mission. Falcon neither has the volume nor the mass to orbit capability required for Starlink 2.0, Musk said. So even if we shrunk the Starlink satellite down, the total up mass of Falcon is not nearly enough to do Starlink 2.0, he explained. We need Starship to work and fly frequently, or Starlink 2.0 will be stuck on the ground, Musk said. A Starship is expected to be capable of deploying up to 400 Starlink satellites to orbit on a single mission, which will enable SpaceX to rapidly complete building the broadband constellation. According to Musk's slide deck, SpaceX's Starlink satellite internet constellation has secured close to 500,000 customers in 32 countries, 2.5 years after operational satellite launches began. The constellation has almost 2,400 working satellites in orbit, of which almost 1,800 are operational. There's a good chance that half of all active satellites will be owned and operated by SpaceX within the next few months. SpaceX has also delivered more than 15,000 Starlink dishes to war-torn Ukraine and announced its first airline connectivity partnerships within the last few months. Elon Musk, the CEO, published the first official renders of SpaceX's next-generation Starlink V2.0 satellites and the massive PES dispenser-style mechanism Starships will initially use to deploy the massive spacecraft in orbit. Based on the renders, SpaceX appears to have more or less upscaled its existing rectangular Starlink V1X satellite design by a factor of 2. Producing a spacecraft that will measure about 7 by 3 meters, 23 by 10 feet. Curiously, the Starlink dispenser and tiny payload slot shown only appear to allow Starship to carry around 60 satellites. Suggesting that the company will need to develop a different deployment method to achieve its ultimate goal of launching 110 to 120 satellites at once. In May 2020, SpaceX requested a permit from the FCC to operate nearly 30,000 satellites in a new generation Starlink constellation they called Gen-2. This new constellation, as SpaceX explained, would be used to augment the capabilities of the first one and be able to serve more people at higher bandwidth and lower latency than the first generation constellation. In August 2021, SpaceX requested an amendment to the FCC to include two possible scenarios for this constellation, Configuration 1 and Configuration 2. Configuration 1 would make use of Starship for the launch and deployment of all the satellites of this new constellation, as well as have a modified number of shells and orbital planes than the original. Configuration 2 would make use of Falcon 9 for launching and deploying all satellites, with its corresponding arrangement of orbital shells, planes, and satellites per plane. Last month, the FCC sent a letter to SpaceX asking for more details about this amendment. As expected, SpaceX replied this week, responding to each of the questions and providing some interesting information. The letter's introduction opens with SpaceX complaining to the FCC, both about the lateness of the approval for filling and the lack of similar questions asked to other would-be competitors of Starlink. SpaceX then noted that it has opted to go with configuration 1-inch instead of configuration 2-inch as an update to their plan, which translates to launching this second generation of Starlink satellites into orbit, using Starship instead of Falcon 9. SpaceX expanded by adding that it wants to operate both constellations simultaneously. Noting, just as terrestrial wireless networks meet customer demands, by operating more than one generation of technology simultaneously, SpaceX plans to use both of its networks to provide superior service. This includes launching replacement satellites later down the line, to keep the first generation constellation serviced while deploying GEN2 satellites. SpaceX also said that customer user terminals would be able to communicate through both constellations. SpaceX has now reached a point in the development of its Starship launch vehicle and GEN2 satellites that it can concentrate solely on configuration 1 and no longer pursue configuration 2. SpaceX confirms here that it still intends to begin launching the GEN2 system as early as end of 2022, likely beginning with the 43-degree or 53-degree inclined planes. "We need Starship to work and fly frequently or Starlink 2.0 will be stuck on the ground," Musk said. Starship is currently under development at the Starbase facility, located at Boca Chica Beach, Texas. The company is pending regulatory approval to perform the first ever orbital flight test this year. The U.S. Federal Aviation Administration has been working on completing an environmental assessment for roughly 11 months, which caused SpaceX to delay attempting to launch a Starship to orbit. The FAA announced it plans to complete the assessment by June 13. Once complete, SpaceX will be able to apply for a spaceflight license to launch a Starship launch vehicle prototype to orbit. Musk previously said that SpaceX will launch thousands of Starlink satellites before launching any humans aboard Starship. Boca Chica Village residents have seen the Starship SN24 prototype features a payload cargo door that looks like it could be a Starlink satellite dispenser. It is unknown whether SpaceX plans to deploy Starlink satellites on a debut flight or just test the cargo door mechanism in microgravity. Starship SN24 is the vehicle that engineers are ground testing to conduct the orbital flight test. Thanks for watching this video, and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, make sure to subscribe. If you have any crazy ideas about what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we'll see if we can get to it. So thanks again for watching and goodbye.